I grew up in Bangor, Pennsylvania, not far from where J.W. Pepper is, actually. And I always knew I was a musician. I don't know if it was because my family was so musical. My grandparents were both church musicians. My mother was a church organist for many years. It's how she put me through college, actually. And I just always had a love of music and of singing in particular. So my parents, when I was in fourth grade, saw an opportunity for me to audition for a boys' choir. And so I went to audition for the Singing Boys of Pennsylvania, who were located in the Lehigh Valley of Pennsylvania, and got into their touring group and spent the next 5 years touring nationally and internationally doing serious choral concerts with this boys choir, and it was just a perfect fit for me. I knew from the beginning. Followed that up with a private voice teacher in high school, which led me to Ithaca College. She had had some students go to Ithaca and was very happy with their voice program there. Ithaca provided me a fantastic education as a voice major and an education major. They had a double major, and I didn't know if I wanted to be on stage or teaching music, and then I really had a life-changing event my senior year of college when I went out to do my student teaching with an inspirational woman who had changed my life. Her name is Bonnie Nye, and she was a high school choral director in Syracuse, New York. And I spent those several weeks with Bonnie and her students, just a fire ignited in me that made it so clear that the joy for me of music making is in the teaching and in bringing it to younger people and helping them achieve their musical goals. So that made it very clear to me that I wanted to be a music teacher. And then I entered music teaching right after college. Taught at a medium-sized high school in upstate New York for 10 years. Had a wonderful program there, lots of community support. Learned so much from those kids and that community and my fellow teachers, which led me to a career change, because as my classroom was growing and growing and growing in that school, I started to feel a desire to maybe have a bigger classroom, if you will. And so my relationship with Sally Albrecht and Jay Althaus began when I was a school teacher, high school teacher. I was singing with Sally and Jay on the demo recordings, the recordings that you hear here at Peppard. And Sally and Jay and I became friends, and they kind of saw my desire to reach out and do something more than what I was doing. And they had an interest in Alfred's choral department growing, and so the opportunity came and the timing was right that they invited me to be part of the Alfred editorial team. And that kind of brings me where I am today. I worked alongside Sally and Jay for about 10, 12 years, and they have since retired, and now I've moved into a bigger editorial position. And along the years, I've been inspired by them as writers and teachers. Sally's a wonderful teacher. I think, like a lot of musicians, I just love making music. And so think about yourself out there if you're a listener. You work, your job is music, and then you get in the car to go away from your job and you probably are listening to music. And then what do you do after dinner? You probably go to choir rehearsal. And on Saturday, what do you do for fun? You probably go to a concert. If you love music, you love music, and I get a lot from it. It fills me in a really special way. It is who I am, it speaks to the man inside. And as far as my balancing conducting jobs that I do along with my writing and editing, those sometimes feel like a time crunch to fit in, but every time I return from one of those, I am so ignited by music education again. It doesn't matter the age of the singer, it doesn't matter the size of the city I was in or the quality of the choir even, just being able to take a young musician from point A to point B is what fuels me every day. And that is where I come up with my ideas for new songs, to be honest. I almost always return from a conducting gig with a new song coming in my head. What would those kids have sounded great on? What would really spoke to that choir? And that kind of gets me rolling on the next project. I am a musical theater guy. I can't help it. My favorite composer is Alan Menken, because he just nails it, and his melodies are magical, and he takes us to a new place. And I love music that tells a story, so what better genre than musical theater? I like the oldest stuff there is in the book, Rodgers and Hammerstein, you know, Gershwin's, Porter, all that. I like all the stuff in between with Sondheim and Schwartz. I like the new guys, Jason Robert Brown and Lin-Manuel Miranda now is killing it. So that's my music. And I don't write musical theater, I write choral music, but if you listen closely, you're going to hear the theater in there.